Hi, welcome to Learning Monkey. I am Vikram. In this class, we will try to understand triggering mechanism of flip-flop. So in our previous class, the different types of triggering mechanisms that are available, we have discussed it clearly about those concepts. If you haven't watched that video, please watch that video and come back here. And every video in our channel is going to be a part of entire course or a playlist. Our suggestion is to follow the entire course so that you can have better understanding of the concepts. And the link for the playlist is provided in the description below. Now coming to this class, there in our previous class, what we have seen is there are four types of triggering mechanisms in the clock. So the clock that we are going to provide to the flip-flop, that the way in which that flip-flop will get triggered, triggering means the input will be entered into the effect of the input will be created on the flip-flop only when the clock is triggered, in the sense only when the clock is one. So that we are going to do it in four different ways. One is positive level triggering, other one is negative level triggering, and the third one is positive edge triggering, and the fourth one is negative edge triggering. So these concepts we have discussed. So now what we are going to do is, given a clock is a continuous generation of zeros and ones. So and given an input of D flip-flop, this is a D flip-flop, that the input is given to this D flip-flop. Now if the clock is positive level, how the output will be? If the clock is negative level, how the output will be? If the clock is positive edge, then how the output will be? And if it is negative edge, how the output will be? That we will try to understand in this class. Now coming here, this is a D flip-flop and the input is in this way, and the first output, the first clocking mechanism, clock triggering mechanism is positive level triggering. So what does that mean is, whenever the positive level triggering means, whenever the input is 1 and it is level triggered, so this is the complete time within which we can, the input that we are going to transmit to the flip-flop, that input will create an effect on the flip-flop. So the input will get changed in this period of time. So whenever there is a positive level, so at all those positive levels, the input, the effect of the input will get created. Otherwise, there will not be any effect on the input. So that is what we call it as positive level triggering. So now coming to this, this is the input that is created and this is the clock. In comparison with these two, we are going to generate the output. So positive level, so which means that at this level, so at this clock input, there will not be any effect of the output. So this is going to be zero. So the input that we are going to provide, it remains the same at this point of time. So whenever we come across with this level input, this is the time period within which the input will get affected. So the output will get affected based upon the input. So now at this level, the input has been changed to 1. So what is the principle of deep flip-flop? If the input is 0, the output is going to 0. If the input is 1, the output is going to be 1. So now this is our first, this is where the clock will work. So now here the input is 1, so the output is going to be 1, and here the input has been changed to 0, so now the output will change to 0. So this is the place within which the output will have an effect based upon the input. That point is very, very important, and this kind of clock triggering is what we call it as positive level triggering. Okay, so now this is the place where the positive level triggering will end and it is going to be 0. So now at 0, there will not be any effect of the input. Whatever the change in the input, it will not get affected. So till here, so from here onwards, the level triggering has been occurring. So this is level triggering. So this is the time period where the output is going to get affected based upon the input. So here the input is 1. So 1 will get created, and again it has been changed to 0. So whenever the input is 0, the output is also going to be 0. So that is the principle of D flip-flop. So again, at the end of this place, that has been changed to 1, and it will remain 1 here, and it will continue to be remained 1. So even though there is a change in 1 to 0, it will not get affected because the level is a negative level. So only at the positive level the effect will get created. So now at this point there is a 0, and here the clock effect will work. So now it will get reduced, it will get converted to 0, and it will remain 0. And here is a negative clock, so the effect is going to be 0 continuously, and here also it is 0, so it will remain 0. So this is how the output is going to be in the level triggering D flip flop. If the clock triggering is negative level, how the output will be, that we will try to understand. So what is a negative level triggering? So whenever the clock is at this level, so this is what we call it as a negative level triggering. Okay. So the effect is going to get created whenever the clock is a negative level. So this is initially, this is also a negative level, this is also a negative level. So initially the input is 0. So here whatever the changes in the input, that will get created, that will create an effect on the output. So here it is 0, and here again it has been suddenly changed to 1, and here this is positive level. So there will not be any effect on the input. The change in the input will not get affected on the output. So this is going to be continuously 1. And now negative level has been started. Now it is going to be a 0. So 0. And suddenly after some time 1 will get created. 1 has been generated in the input. And here it is positive level. So it is going to remain 1 until this time period. So now we are going to get a negative level, and this is the input, this is going to be positive. So it remains positive till here, and here it is changing to 0, and this is positive level triggering, and here it will remain the same. And negative level triggering 0, and here the change is happening, so it is going to be 1, and before the end it has been converted to 0. So it will get converted to 0 because this is positive level triggering, it remains the same. So this is going to be the output for negative level triggering. And our next kind of triggering is positive edge triggering. So what is this positive edge triggering? Positive edge triggering means this is a positive edge. Okay, so this is a positive level triggering, this is negative. Okay, this is a negative level triggering, and this one is a positive edge triggering. So whenever the transition is done from 0 to 1, so whenever the transition is moving up, so at this transition, at this point of time, so for example, for this transition to happen, if it is taking 1 second, it will not take 1 second, because for better understanding we are taking it as 1 second. So for 1 second the input will get affected, the input will enter into the circuit. So the effect of the input will happen only for this period of time. So until it will reach from here to here, for that period of time the input will get, the effect of the input will get created on the output, and for the remaining time it will remain constant, in the sense it is not going to create any changes on the inputs. So now based upon the D flip flop, here this is a level trigger, this is level, so here the input will not have any effect, so it is going to be 0. because it starts with 0, and here at this edge we are creating an input of 1. So 1 will get created, and this 1 will remain. This input 1, the effect that is created by this input 1 is going to be at the output is 1, and this 1 is going to remain until we get another positive edge triggered, edge triggering happens, which means till here the 1 will remain the same. Okay, so this 1 till here it will remain the same. Here again it is 1, sorry, here, so again it is 1. So even though here we are having 1 to 0 and 0 to 1, a transition is happening in the input, it will not get create any effect on the output, because the inputs are taken only when it is edge triggering. So because at the edge it is 1, it will remain 1 until the edge triggering happens. Again here the edge triggering happens, here the input is 0. So now see here, here the input is 0, so here it is going to change to 0. So till where it is going to be 0? Till here it will remain 0. So till here it will remain 0, again the input is 0, so it will remain 0. Okay, so this is the how the edge trigger flip-flop will work, and positive edge trigger flip-flop will work, and this is a negative edge trigger. So what is meant by negative edge triggering? Whenever the transition is done from 1 to 0, so whenever the edge is falling down, so this is what we call it as a negative edge triggering. This is what we call it as a negative edge triggering. So now negative edge triggering, how the input is going to be, this is a level triggering. So here the input is going to be 0. Till where the input is going to 0? Till here it is going to be a 0. See here, till here it is going to be a 0, and now the negative edge trigger has been done. So at this point, what is the input? 0. So this 0 will remain, this 0 will remain until another negative edge triggering happens. This is where the point where the negative edge triggering will continue. So the 0 will continue. So here the input is 1. See here, here the input is 1. So now it will raise to 1. Okay, so it will raise to 1. So we'll take smaller one. So it will raise to 1 and it will remain 1 until here. Okay, so till here it will remain 1. Here the input has been 0. So it will be 0 here and it will remain 0 until here. Okay, so till here, and again it is 0 0, so it will be 0 in this way. So this is a negative edge triggering output. Okay, so we have taken the randomly generated D input, which means the inputs are randomly created. So once it is 0, once it is 0, once it is again, it is converting it to positive. So the better practice, so usually the practice is, so whenever the input is 0, whenever the clock is 0, then only the inputs will change. But here even though the clock is 0, whenever the clock is 0, then only the inputs will change. Even though we are having a clock to be 1, then also there is a change in the input. Usually this kind of inputs will not happen. The inputs will change in the circuit only when the clock signal is at 0 level. Hope you got the clarity on this concept. Thanks for watching. If you haven't subscribed to our channel, please subscribe to our channel and press bell icon for the latest updates. And if you have any doubts regarding this concept, please post your doubt in the comment section below. Thanks for watching.